Praise the Lord, brothers and sisters in the Lord. I bless you all once again in the mighty name of Jesus. This is your usual host, Mrs. Evangelist Egonon. Hallelujah, somebody. I want to give the word of exhortation, which I titled, The Kingdom of Heaven Suffering Violence, and the Violent Took It by Force. Hallelujah, somebody. But before we go for the word, let us pray. Everlasting King of Kings, Eternal Rock of Ages, the God of our ancestors, the Buddha appointed and never consumed. Once again, your word is about to come. Father, say breath on your word. Use your word for as many that are looking into this, channel that they are watching it from, whether it is from Facebook, WhatsApp, YouTube, Messenger, etc., etc., etc. Father, let this word make manifest in their lives. Every spirit of distraction will render all impotent. We nullify them by the power in the name of Jesus. Father, we say, use your word so that the end has made that we listen. Let the word be manifest. Let the word transform them. Let it help them to know the knowledge of what the word is talking about so that they can use it to bear fruit and make disciples. And in the end, all glory and adoration will be given to you, God Almighty. I say, take all the glory, take all the adoration, God Almighty, for in Jesus' almighty name I have prayed. Amen. Viewers all over the world, as I initially said, I want to give a word of exhortation, which I said I titled, The Kingdom of Heaven Suffering Violence, and the Violence Took It by Force. Amen, somebody. Today, in our individual lives, many of us, we have come across a storm. Thank God we are passing through it, we are coming across it, we are not going to remain there. But I want to use myself as an example. I came out to give this one word of God because of what is happening to me now. Hallelujah, somebody. We are parents. As an evangelist, the Bible says, train up a child in the book of Proverbs chapter 22, verse 6, the way he or she will grow, so that when he or she grow, he or she will never depart from it. Hallelujah. Amen. Church is started from home. My children now, as I'm talking to you now, they are in the hand of, the human right. The Italian call it socially. Amen. Just because of correcting them of what they are doing is not good, they use their leg to march to the police, and the police cannot end it up there. They went to the place they are calling social. In English, we call them human rights. As I'm talking to you now, they are with the social. But the joy I have is that they were thinking maybe when they go to report, they will arrest me or my husband, or they will leave them free to move around the world. But I'm here to tell you, the Bible says in the book of, I think, Ezekiel chapter 3, verse 16, he told Ezekiel, this is God Almighty, sending prophet Ezekiel to go and tell us many of the children of God, not only the Israelites. Hallelujah, somebody, because if you believe in God, you believe that God sent only his begotten son to come and die for you here, and you confess with your mouth, you believe with your heart, you are not a child of God. You are not the sons and daughters of God Almighty. This message is for you. Hallelujah, somebody. It's not only for the Israelites. The Bible said God sent prophet Ezekiel to go and tell the people of Israel, many that are doing things that are contrary to the principles of God, things that are bringing anger to the heart of God, that are bringing anger to the kingdom of God. Ezekiel should go and tell them through the word of God. Ezekiel, studied in the scripture to go and tell them whatever they are doing that is not right, that is not going rhyme with the scripture, that Ezekiel should let them know they are putting themselves in danger. Amen, somebody. So we need to encourage people. We need to teach the people the word of God. We need to use the word of God to correct them. The book of 2 Timothy said, or 1 Timothy, if I'm not mistaken, 3:16, that the word of God is for correction. It is to correct us. We don't need to see people having an error, doing something that is not among the principles as a child of God. We need to use the word of God to correct them. Hey, what you are doing is not good. Use it to correct them. God sent prophet Ezekiel to go and tell them that whatever they are doing that is not right, it should correct them through the scripture. That if Ezekiel did like that, when they die, or those things they are doing that will cause them into a sin, will lead them to death, Ezekiel's hand will be cleared. But if Ezekiel refused to correct them, refused to put them in order to use the word of God to correct them, when they die or whatever happened to them as a penalty, Ezekiel will bear the responsibility. He will be held responsible. Amen. That is why I came up with such an exhortation. Amen, somebody. My children, they are doing things that is not right with the scripture. As a good example, I come up every time to speak the word of God to people. But yet, they ignore me because they saw that I did not stand to accept the area they were going driving at. They went to the police. Glory be to God. They will learn a lesson from there. Amen. They are coming out after 18 years, but they are going to learn from there because I thank God in everything. We need to give glory to God. Maybe there is a purpose God wants them to go and report themselves. I, their parents, supposed to go and report them, but because of they refuse to correct themselves through the encouragement I'm giving them through the word of God, the knowledge of God that God put in me, they now find themselves reporting themselves to the police and they see themselves in that hand of human rights here in Italy, which we call them social. Amen. I thank God they have an understanding. Maybe after we go to court, we do everything. They will not regret why they went to go and report. And I thank God. I pray that God Almighty is going to use people there working under that human right to correct them, the error they are making. I don't think they are going to go there to pretend and hide that character. May God help us all in Jesus' name. Hallelujah, somebody. Amen, somebody. So I came up with such an exhortation because many people have faced storm in the scripture. I've used John the Baptist before when he was arrested by King Herod. The Bible says he's like he made the word of God a non-effect. The Bible says the disciples of Jesus, John the Baptist sent them to Jesus because they saw Jesus where he was performing miracles, healing people, making the deaf to hear, making the dumb to speak, making the lame to stand on their feet. When they came to Jesus, I have many occasions I've used this scripture, but I'm here to use this again because of what my children did. One is almost 18 years, 5 months to 18 years. One is just maybe a few days, less than a month, 2 weeks to be 15 years. Amen. They thought the way I handled them, I'm intimidating them. But I'm here to tell you, I don't know whatever you are passing through. I came up with such an exhortation because of what is happening to me and my husband. The kingdom of heaven suffered violence, and the violent took it by force. Amen, somebody. We need to use that example of Ezekiel. When you allow things to rough out, you are seeing people going astray. You did not correct them with the word of God. You did not correct them with the wisdom God put in you. God will withdraw that wisdom away because the word of God is for correction. It's to draw people out of darkness to bring them to light. The word of God is for light. And the evil way of living is for darkness. And we did not belong to the world of darkness. The Bible says we are in the world, but we shouldn't allow the worldly things to control us. When you see our children, our husband, our wives, our family, our brethren, they are going astray. We need to speak to them in a meek way. We used to using words of meek, humbleness, like the word of God said in Colossians chapter 4 from verses 4 to 6, that we should speak to people in a humble way, in a meek way. Using it to correct them, not in quarrelsome or in nagging. Amen, somebody. So I came out to encourage you because I don't know the storm you are passing through. I don't know that fire you think that is burning you. I don't know whatever you think that is, you know, is disturbing you now. Hold your peace. It is not going to, you know, remain there forever. Hallelujah, somebody. So John the Baptist saw that he was being in prison. Instead of him to look unto God, the Bible said in Psalm 121 verse 1, I look unto heaven where my help cometh from. And my help cometh from the Lord. That is verse 2. Amen, somebody. John the Baptist sent his disciples to go and meet Jesus, to ask him, is he the Messiah? Are they going to wait for another one? But I'm here to encourage you. I thank God. If you read the book of Matthew chapter 11, I want you to read from verses 1 to end. See the way Jesus responded to the disciples of John the Baptist. He said, go and tell him what you just see here. The power is still available. In other words, he said, tell him, you see the lame, they are standing on their feet. Miracles are happening, different kind of miracle. As they were about to leave, that is where he made sure that the kingdom of heaven suffered violence and the violence took it by force. He let them know that John the Baptist is the one that, you know, had baptized him, prepared the way for him. Amen. Before he started his ministry, Jesus was saying this. He said, but John the Baptist is the one that went to the desert, to the wilderness, to preach the gospel, to say, repent for the kingdom of God is at hand. He said, John the Baptist is the greatest among all men born of a woman. He said, but now, because of the way John the Baptist, is doing now. He said the least in the kingdom, ordinary people, they are now greater than John the Baptist. In other words, the power is still available. In other words, kingdom of heaven suffering violence, and the violence took it by force. Brothers and sisters in the Lord, I don't know what is happening to you now. I don't know what did you not expect that will happen to you, and it happened to you of a sudden. Just like the examples I gave concerning myself. They are my children. I love them. Even tomorrow, they come out from the social. My second son and my third, my daughter, my fourth one, they are the one that did these things. But I'm still standing still, believing in God Almighty, looking unto heaven where my help coming from, because I know my help coming from God Almighty. He will not leave me to remain in this desolation, in the agony. Amen, somebody. We are coming out of it. And I rebuke anything that will make me not to come out of it in Jesus' name. I bring them down by the power in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. So I'm here to use myself now as an clear example. I don't know what you are passing through. It is not easy for your children that have grown, especially the old one that is 18 years, to go and tell the police, they call them carabinieri, that we are beating him. We are making him, you know, not to have peace in the house where he lives. It's a lie. He wants to parabolate the whole Verona where we live. He wants to see everything just under a day. It is not so. We need to train up a child the way he or she will grow, so that when he or she grow, he will not depart from them. The word of God is yea and amen. When you allow the word of God to enter you and begin to settle in you and use you, you avail yourself for the Holy Spirit. Sky will be your limit. I don't know who is listening to the sound of my voice. I want all child that are matured a little to listen to this word of exhortation. Amen, somebody. We need the word of God said in that Matthew 11. That the kingdom of heaven suffered violence, the violence took it by force. Amen, somebody. When you look at the book of Luke chapter 8 from verse 22 there, the Bible says Jesus and his disciples, they were inside the boat. Of a sudden, there was a storm and the disciples were grumbling. We are the children of God. We are his disciples of today. I don't know what is happening to you. I don't know the storm you formed yourself like the disciples of Jesus. He said one day Jesus got into a boat with his disciples. I'm reading Luke chapter 8 from verse 22. I'm using Good News Version. So they started out. As they were sailing, Jesus fell asleep. Suddenly a strong wind blew them on the lake, and the boat began to fill with water, so that they were all in great danger. The disciples went to Jesus and woke him up, saying, Master, Master, we are about to die. They were afraid. Fear gripped them, enter into them because of storm, because of wave. Hallelujah, somebody. But I'm here to encourage you with this one word of exhortation, that the kingdom of heaven suffered violence, and the violence took it by force. Look at what Jesus said. Jesus got up and gave an order to the wind and the storm, stormy water, and they died there, and there was a great calm. Then he said to the disciple, where is your faith? Hallelujah, somebody. We need to have faith. If you have a little faith like a mustard seed, no matter the storm that is around you, no matter the land that is desolate, stand firm. Don't allow what you see to shake you. But remember what the word of God said. The Bible says he stretched to the storm, began to use the word of God to destroy whatever that is not of God that is happening in your territory. I am here to use this one word to make you to be, you know, bold and courageous. As Jesus said, as the word of God said in the book of Joshua chapter 1, if you read from verses 7 down, he said, be bold and courageous. But one thing, don't allow this one word of God to depart from your mouth. As you meditate on this word, as you study the word day and night, you begin to see, you'll be equipped with the word of God. No matter the storm that you pass through, no matter the agony, no matter the land that is desolate, no matter what will happen around you, between you and your children, between you and your marriage, your husband, even your working place, your business, your family, your church, even the agent of darkness are sending arrow. The Bible says 1,000 will fall here, 10,000 here. None of them will come near you. I am here, beloved brothers and sisters in the Lord, to encourage you to stir up your spirit. I don't know what you are passing through. I don't know that land that is desolate, as I initially said. Began to use the word of God to destroy them, to put them their stronghold down, as the book of, I think, 2 Corinthians chapter 10, verses 1 and 5 said. Hallelujah, somebody. Put their stronghold down by the word of God, by that word of knowledge you have in you. He said, meditate on this word, let it not depart from you. He said, be bold and courageous. As you meditate on the word of God, you begin to use the word of God to destroy whatever ugly situation that is around you. Jesus calmed the storm. The disciples were afraid. This is exactly the picture we are seeing. When this thing happened initially, I always almost lose control. But I thank God for the power of God, for the great men and women of God. I said, on the YouTube, I began to see great men and women of God giving me the word of Kabbalah, the word of encouragement through the word of God. Then strength came back to me. Hallelujah, somebody. I don't know what you are passing through now. Hallelujah. I don't know the problem that is confronting you. Remember, even in the book of Genesis, what happened to Joseph? When the brothers saw his dreams, they were thinking to kill him. They put him in a well that there is no water. But later they saw all these traders passing by going to Egypt. They took him up, they sold him. They went to go and kill animals, use his blood to rub clothes and told the father that is dead. But if the oil of God is on your head, no matter the storm, no matter the land, no matter the land that is desolate, no matter the problem that is confronting you, God will always see you through. Even the Israelites, when they were back crossing the Red Sea, Jesus asked them, what do you have, Moses, as their leader? He said, the stick that is the word of God. He stretched it. Use the word of God to destroy every storm that is around you. No matter the arrow of the enemy, no matter the affliction, begin to use the word of God to destroy them. That 1,000 will fall, 10,000, nothing will come to you in Jesus' name. Hallelujah, somebody. This is what our Lord can do. The word of God is here. Amen. Don't be afraid like Peter. Don't allow your circumstances to sink you down. Like Peter was seeing the storm, began to get afraid, and he sank, if not Jesus, that took him up again. That word of God is there. The Bible says in the book of Revelation 3 or so, it says falling is not the problem. Realizing you are falling and you come back to your feet, that is what our God wants us to do. Uncountable time you fell down is not the problem, but you have to rise up on your feet and begin to use the word of God to maintain your standing so that you will not fall again. Hallelujah, somebody. I don't know who this message is referring to. We have seen this example of Joseph, what the brother did. The Israelites, how they parted the Red Sea to that power of God that was on that stick, that mantle Moses was holding. Hallelujah. The word of God is valid. The Bible says, heaven and earth will pass away. The word of God remain here and amen. The word of God is here and amen, brothers and sisters. Hold on to the word of God. Call on that name and you will see victory will be your portion in Jesus' name. I am here to use this word of God to encourage you. I don't know what you are looking unto God for. I don't know that pain you are passing through now. Is this sickness? Use the word of God to command the sickness to go away. And the doctor will pronounce this is going to happen, but they will see you moving on. I'm a living testimony. Brothers and sisters in the Lord, I don't know what you are passing through, but remember the word of God is here. Amen. The kingdom of heaven suffered violence, and the violent took it by force. In the book of 2 Chronicles or 1 Chronicles, chapter 4, verses 9 and 10, we know a man called Jabez. The Bible said the meaning of Jabez means sorrow. May God let us not live a life of sorrow. But the Bible said he called unto God in prayer and supplication that God remove away this sorrow from me. Give me joy. Give me riches. Let my land be full of meekness. The Bible said God answers his heart desire. I don't know what you are passing through. I don't know that matter that is before you. But the word of God said in Jeremiah chapter 23, verse 29, he said, my word, is it not like a hammer? Is my word not like a fire? King James, you know, version. He said, that breaketh the rock and the mountain to pieces. The word of God is like a hammer. The word of God is like a fire that breaketh the rock to pieces. I am here, beloved brothers and sisters, to encourage you to stir up your spirit, because many of us today, we are passing through pain. Many of us here in Italy, they did not give us documents. They are giving them negative. But you have to call unto God Almighty, the beginning and the end of your faith. He is there to direct you, the path you will follow, so that in the end, all glory and adoration will be given to you because of the joy you now have. Because you look unto him. Study the word of God, beloved. I want you to hold on to the word of God. The word of God is here. Amen. Heaven and earth will pass away. The word of God will never pass away. The Bible says, with men it might be impossible, but with God all things are possible to them that believe. I thank God Almighty for his word. I thank God Almighty for empowering me. Because of this, my issue that is on the ground now, we have not yet gone to court. But I believe in the God that I'm serving, that I'm coming out victoriously. I believe 100%. I told my husband not to wave, not to shake. Amen, somebody. I don't know the spirit that have entered those children, but by the power and that resurrection in the name of Jesus, I command such evil spirit that is in them, whatever make them to walk to the police where we are correcting them for good, they take it for evil. May the fire of God consume those things out of their life in Jesus' name. And I'm using it to pray to you as a point of contact. I don't know what is happening in your home. I don't know what is happening in your family. I don't know what is happening in your ministry. I don't know what is happening in your life in particular. But I'm here to pray for you this hour that God Almighty, who has sent only his begotten son to die for me and you and for the whole world when we were yet a sinner, when many of us have not yet known him, he died, and in that cross he said, "It is finished." That is why he died. He take our position, and the third day he resurrected. I release that power of resurrection upon you right now to break every yoke upon you. I release the oil of God upon you. That anointing in Isaiah 10:27. He said, because of the anointing, every yoke will be broken. As you are listening to the sound of my voice, by the power in the name of Jesus, by that power that bestowed in Isaiah 10:27, I command that anointing to rest upon you. Anything that is like a land of desolation, that is like a storm in your life, that is like a mountain in your life, I command all to roll away in the name of Jesus. I set you free and I set you loose. I break every yoke out of your life. I release the power of God upon you to do exploit, the wisdom and understanding and knowledge of God upon you, for you to do exploit in the name of Jesus. I say, go and possess your possession in Jesus' name. I decree that 1,000 will fall here, 10,000, they will not come near you in the mighty name of Jesus. I stand in the word of God in the book of Joel chapter 2 verse 25 to restore in your life and your family life and your ministry life and your brethren's life that all the canker on the caterpillar have stolen to be restored 100-fold in Jesus' name. The sickness is not for the children of God. From the crown of your head to your toe, I release the healing power of God upon you. I release that blood of Jesus upon you from the crown of your head to toe. That whatever that is a yoke of sickness in you, I command them to be broken out by the power in the name of Jesus. Every monitoring spirit that is around you, around your household, around your ministry, around your brethren, by the power in the name of Jesus, I command them to blind. They will blind spiritual and physical in Jesus' name. As many that say they will not leave you alone until they succeed, I command the angels of war, the angel Michael, to come the way from heaven to fight every battle for you and your household. For in Jesus' almighty name, I pray for you. I pray for doors of favor to open for you. I pray for doors of just opportunity upon your life and your household and your ministry and your families and your brethren in the mighty name of Jesus. I pray for God to open your spiritual eye for you to see with your spiritual eye, not your physical eye, in the mighty name of Jesus. I pray for you to have the spirit of discernment, to understand the things concerning the spirit, in the mighty name of Jesus. I say, go and do exploit. Go and possess your possession. I decree once again in your life, in the mighty name of Jesus, you will begin to be the head, never the tail, a victor, not a victim, a conqueror and a champion of all champions, a winner in the mighty name of Jesus. And above all, I pray and I decree every purpose of God in your life, the reason why God created you, I decree all to come to accomplishment. For in Jesus' almighty name, I have prayed. Amen. Brothers and sisters in the Lord, I just want to give you this few words of exhortation just because of what is happening in my home now. I want to let you know that the kingdom of heaven suffered violence and the violence took it by force. Hallelujah, somebody. Amen, somebody. We also know in the book of Matthew, there I'm rounding up now, that the Bible says a man planted something in his vineyard, in his farm, but in the night an enemy came to also plant his own. But the servant wanted to remove it. Their master said, no, don't remove them. Let them grow. When they grow, they will know the difference. I pray for you once again that you will know the meaning of the word of God. This word of God will let you know from the right to left. We know who is your enemy, who is your friend. As many that pretend to be your friend, they will be an enemy. May God open your spiritual eye to know them so that when you are matured, you can remove them out of your way so that things will go well for you and your household. For in Jesus' almighty name, I pray. I say, remain blessed until I see you next time. I say, subscribe. Only 16 people subscribe. And I have more than 200 followers in my YouTube, in my Facebook, in my WhatsApp, and in my Messenger. I say, may God bless you until I come your way again. Share up for people, and God will bless you. For in Jesus' name, amen. Bye-bye. Until I come your way next time. Amen. Hallelujah, somebody.